Hello friends, Mandar here. I'm back with another video. Today I'm going to talk about provincial nominee program, but specifically for paper-based application. So if you are somebody who is interested in Canada immigration and who is not sure that they will get through the express entry program, and the only option that they see is provincial nominee program, then you might want to watch this video until the end. So now let's get started. If you are here for the first time, welcome. My name is Mandar and I make immigration related videos for US and Canada. If you like this video and if it is useful to you, please hit the like button and consider subscribing to my channel. Now let's get started. Now first of all, let's look at who is this process useful for. So today we are talking about provincial nominee program, but paper-based process. I made an earlier video on provincial nominee program and I explained how there are two types of provincial nominee program. One is tied to express entry program, where you get the provincial nomination first and then go back to your express entry profile and submit your provincial nomination there. So you get additional 600 points that almost makes you guaranteed approval for federal express entry program. Well, it may not be always, but it will highly increase your chances for federal express entry approval. Now, what I'm talking about in this video is the other method of provincial nominee program, which is totally independent of express entry. It is administered by each individual province. So each individual provinces have their provincial nominee program and there are different categories within that. So they call it streams. Now these streams are based upon the needs of that particular province. If a particular province in short of skilled trade workers, say farmers or doctors or nurses or caregivers, they may start a pilot program to attract people from that particular area. Now, some of these applications are done paper-based, and that's why it's called paper-based application. Typically, a two-stage process where you get an approval or provincial nomination, and then you submit a paper application to the province to get the final approval for your PR. There are certain expectations by the province that they will expect you to live and work in that particular province. They may also have some additional requirements that we'll get into. First of all, you make an application for this PNP program, and the province will decide whether they will nominate you. The key factor in this is the province should be convinced that you intend to live in that province and work in that province for a certain duration at the least. If they are convinced and if you meet all their other requirements, then you will get a nomination. You take that nomination approval and apply to the IRCC and get your PR application approved. So that is the second step. The total processing time of this type of application, which is paper-based, is slightly longer than express entry. In express entry, you may receive your approval within 6 months, but this process can take anywhere between a year and a half to 2 years. So as I mentioned earlier, each individual province will have their separate requirements for this type of provincial nominee program. So Alberta's provincial nominee program is entirely different than Ontario's, and that is different than Nova Scotia. There is a central theme here that they are similar in the sense that they are administered by the province themselves, but that's where the similarities end. So because these are so different from province to province, and I'm going to select Alberta and walk you through that process. So Alberta's PNP process is called AINP, Alberta Immigration Nominee Program. So this is particularly for people who intend to live and work in Alberta. Now there is selection criteria, there is specific stream, as I said, depending on the need of the province. So there is a stream called Alberta Opportunity Stream. The basic requirement is you must have a valid temporary resident status in Canada that will allow you to move to Alberta and work there. So at the time of application, it is very critical that you have this work permit. So how do you get this work permit? So valid work permits are dependent on one of the below. One is positive LMIA, which is labor market impact assessment, that is done by your employer. So you already have a job and you are working in it, your employer can do LMIA. What it does is it tells IRCC that there is no qualified candidate in the province, so they intend to hire you. There is also LMIA exemption, which means that you don't need to do this LMIA if you are in one of these categories: international trade agreements, work transferred between the company, international experience Canada, and there are certain vulnerable employees or workers who have demonstrated that they were abused or are in risk of abuse in terms of their employment, which will qualify them for vulnerable worker open work permit. The family members also get a work permit. If you have an advanced degree from Alberta University, you also get a postgraduate open work permit. Who are the people who are not applicable or not eligible? Certain refugees are certain people who are in the removal proceedings. Temporary workers who are living in other provinces and have no intention to live in Alberta. And foreign migrants who have stayed in Canada and have overstayed their visa and do not carry a valid temporary resident status. Now there is a list of NOC codes, which is National Occupation Code List, which you can go through in the link that I will provide in the description. Now there is also English language requirement. You need to have CLB 7 as a minimum requirement for Alberta in specific. So there is education requirement as well for people who have studied within Alberta. You must have been studied through an accredited institution in Alberta, and the list is also in the link. And then there is qualifying work experience. If you have lived in Alberta and worked in Alberta for the last 12 to 18 months, that is considered very positive. Also, there is a requirement for minimum of 24 months of occupation or experience, which may be within Canada or outside of Canada. Now, as I said, once you have all the application packet ready, you can send it by post to a certain address that is listed on the website. So this is a paper application. You need to fill out all the information and have a physical signature and send it to an office in Alberta. This is a mail-in application you do for Alberta Opportunity Stream. So depending on your documentation, your interest and intent to live in Alberta and work in Alberta, this Alberta Opportunity Stream may be of interest to you. I typically recommend this to people who are above 35 and who may not qualify for a federal express entry program, to look at such streams such as Alberta for provincial nominee program and specifically for paper-based application. The information provided in this video is only for educational purpose. If you have a specific immigration need for PNP, I highly recommend that you work with a competent lawyer. If you find this information useful, please hit the like button and consider subscribing to my channel. And I will see you in the next one.